My name is Paul, and I'm going to pull my scripture. I'm one of the members of the, now we have a healthcare provider committee here at LOFT as of this Thursday. So as a community of faith, we live in the context of everything that is happening around us in the world. And as most of you may have heard in the news, there's a lot of attention being paid to the emergence of this virus, this coronavirus called COVID-19. And so we wanted to talk a little bit about that and steps that we are taking here at LOFT just to be ready. So right now, there have been no cases in North Texas of this infection, and the risk currently in our community remains very, very low. That said, we want to let you know about the steps we are taking to try to maintain a safe and healthy environment for everyone attending our services and in our congregation. So there are some changes that you may start noticing today or in the coming weeks, and so we, as good medical professionals, based it upon the advice of people smarter than us, and so we look to the CDC to see what they have to say. So we have a little cartoon picture here. Okay. So you may have seen these signs kind of hanging around, and these are common sense things that we should really be doing all the time. Right now, this has been a really horrible flu season. There have been 40 million cases of flu, 300,000 infections. There have been, over 125 kids who have died, which is the most in over 10 years. So these are things that will prevent that too. And so these are good things to keep in mind. But especially now with this emergence of this new thing, this new virus, COVID, we're emphasizing them more. So I'm just going to go through kind of this section. Can't really read it, so I will read it for you. So the first thing says, how do you prevent spread of disease? You avoid close contact with people who are known to be sick. So in general, this means trying to keep away from people who are visibly sick, and usually about 3 to 6 feet is usually kind of, if you're really sick and coughing, that's where it will spread. So what that means here at LOFT is if you are feeling sick, number one, we encourage you, if you're coughing, if you have fever, not to come, actually, and try to avoid, having lots of people kind of around you. And worship with us online, and we'll have more on this later. Otherwise, if you are sick and you're here and you want to stay, try to just minimize touch, because we're always touching our faces and touching other people. And so try to minimize that among people around you. So that's the first thing, avoid being around sick people. Number two is cover your cough or sneeze with a tissue, and then throw the tissue in the trash. Don't pass it on. So if you do come and you do find that you have a little bit of a sniffle, you don't know if it's allergies, you feel pretty good, you don't think you're getting sick, you don't have a sore throat or anything, you may have noticed that we have tissues now at the seat backs of every chair. In the first row, we have it under the seats. And so we say that if you have a sniffle or have allergies or a runny nose because the weather's changing, feel free to use that and please just take it home. You don't need to be generous and save it for the next person. And so the other thing we would ask is that if you're coughing, please try to cough into the tissue. We have nice receptacles around and throw it away there. Otherwise, try to cough into your elbow. This is kind of the cough as opposed to this, because you usually will end up touching people afterwards. And then if you can, try to sanitize your hands. The third thing here is don't touch your face. So I don't know, this is being taped, and so I'll see how many times I touch my face, but it's really hard not to touch your face. And so try, okay. Next one. It says clean and disinfect high touch areas. So just to let you know what we're doing here. So before and after service, our hospitality team and volunteers here are wiping down areas of high touch. This includes door handles and other places. The teachers will be wiping down the surfaces at kids' church before and after as well. We could use some help. There is another church that uses this space after us, and it would be nice for us to clean up and wipe things down before they come, if we can. So the next one, stay at home when you are sick. So if you're sick, and this is fever, definitely, but also if you're having a sore throat, a really runny nose, things that you know is being passed around in your family, we encourage you to please stay home. And this also applies to kids. And so we have a great web stream. And so I don't know if we have the link up here, but you can log on to our worship services on through YouTube and as well as through Facebook. And so this is the website for you to memorize. And so so we just encourage you guys, and this will be posted on our Facebook page as well as our website. And so if you're not feeling great or you're not sure, better to just stay home and worship with us online. And we'll know you're there because we can see how many people. All right, let's go back to the CDC graphic here. Okay, so the last one, wash your hands often with soap and water for at least 20 seconds. And so we have plenty of soap. There's not a run on soap right now. And we do encourage frequent hand washing. So the key is 20 seconds. You've heard this in the news, right? So how do you do 20 seconds? The easiest thing, you sing happy birthday to you two times, and that's 20 seconds. And so there's also, if you go on Twitter, there's like all the greatest hits that are 20 seconds long. You can sing any of those songs. We'll find a good worship song as well at some point. You'll also notice that we have some hand sanitizing stations around the sanctuary and around the church. These are not easy to find, and so we encourage you to try to use them as you come in and as you exit a space. Also, for all the parents, the kids' ministry leaders will also be giving a dab of sanitizer to kids as they come in and a dab as they go out, as we know they are walking infection. All right, so other things that we will be doing. Okay, so for the time being, changes that you might see in our service. So for the time being, when it comes to greeting each other, we're encouraging people to greet each other with a wave, with a smile, with a fist bump, a peace sign, a bow. We actually have two volunteers who are going to demonstrate, so we can get that graphic up. These are handshake alternatives, and so we'll have our volunteers demonstrate for us. So the first is the wave, so this is the wave. Let's get a round of applause here. Yeah, all right. The next one, this is called, I don't know why it's called this, it's called a tie wai. And so this is, you know, what people, you know, what people do to each other, so. Yeah. The elbow has kind of gained popularity. I would say if you recently coughed into your elbow, not to do this one, right? And then the last one on this is the foot shake. All right. This is also kind of becoming viral. And the last one they don't have up here is the fist bump. So the fist bump, yeah. So that's another one. And so let's have a round of applause for our volunteers here. But basically what this does, by encouraging our congregation to do this, we help everyone avoid the pressure of having to hug or shake hands. We do encourage people at this time, if you want to hug, it's fine, but just to ask for permission. And if they say no, please don't be offended, because it is appropriate at this time. You'll also notice a few other changes in our service, such as the greeting times and at the benediction, when we won't be holding hands for a little while during the benediction. Again, if you're feeling ill or if you've traveled from a high-risk area where it's in the news that there's been lots of community cases, you know, Seattle is one right now, but also countries abroad, or if you're concerned that these steps are just not enough and you're like, you know, the news is scaring you, then we do encourage you to log on to the live stream. Everything I've said today, so that's basically all I have to say, but everything I've said will be uploaded onto our Facebook page and onto our LOFT website after service today as well. There you'll find links to the live stream. We've also put some hopefully helpful links to local health authorities and kind of just where to get information. There's so much bad information going around right now. And so, you know, we're recommending that people just go there and, you know, we'll link you to kind of the CDC and the local departments of health. You know, as Sam mentioned, during times like this, people do tend to be fearful and they may lash out. And there have been reports of bullying, reports of some discrimination and things. So we ask that everyone remain prayerful and sensitive to those around us who may be struggling through this time. Otherwise, we do encourage everyone to listen to local health authorities and follow. These are really common sense precautions, especially people, those who are over 60 years old and who have underlying medical conditions. If you're in this group, we do encourage you to take extra precautions because we are finding that this virus, for most of us, is going to be very mild, but for that population is much more serious. And so we ask that you take some extra precautions, especially in regards to travel and things. And finally, let's be in prayer for those affected around the world and for the vulnerable among us. We believe that even in the midst of global challenges like this, God is present. Amen. We want to demonstrate the love of Christ and support our brothers and sisters. If you have any questions, you can feel free to reach any of us on the healthcare worker committee. So I'm Paul. Molly Fung, I'm going to ask everyone to stand. Molly is there in the back. And Vicky and Michael Mishra, they're also there in the back. And Joyce Verghese, who is not here today, is also on committee. So feel free to reach out to us if you see us with questions. Otherwise, if you want to shoot an email, you can email to info@loftcitychurch.com, and we'll respond.